All right, it's like the 16th of March. St. Patrick's Day 2012 is tomorrow. We're going to cook out. I went up to the store and got some things. The kids are coming over for 3 days. I'm going to go get them here in just about an hour. And we're going to cook out tomorrow outside. Watching a little bit of one of my favorite shows, the DIY show. Anyways, this is the beginning. We're going to do a cookout, and we'll talk more about that later. But happy holiday to everybody. Have a good one. Safe. And we shall, we'll talk to you later. All right, today is St. Patty's Day, 2012, and we're doing some beer can chicken. We're doing two of them, and both of my grills today. That's Tyler's hand is going to help me out here in just a second. I'll show you how my setup is. It takes a lot of prep. We got in this one, there's apple juice, pan, and the chicken is sitting on a beer can, which will steam and all the alcohol will burn out of it, but it keeps it moist. And so this chamber is really going to be real moist. It just got started about 12:15. Let's have a look and see how it is. Okay, here we go. So the beer can is in there. We got oranges and some onion slices that we put into the cavity along on top of the beer can. And this is our apple juice rather, with a little bit of onion I just threw in there because it didn't want to cooperate too well. So it's in there, and of course our fire down below, wood chunks. And so it'll take about 3-4 hours. We'll check it back later. But that's that one. And now let's look at the other one. This is a little different setup. Yeah, go ahead and pop it, man. Okay, our fire, that pan is empty. And the reason it's empty is it so it keeps this fire indirect from the chicken. It's still gonna get hot, but the flame and the heat's coming up around that pan to still give us our indirect. Sitting on a beer can for steam, and it'll bubble out and probably be dry before the chicken's, or about the time the chicken's done, maybe sooner. And here's our fire. We used real wood chunks, cowboy type charcoal there. And that's empty. I might put something in that, haven't decided, probably not. And beer can on the chicken to keep it moist, so it ought to be good. Again, there's onions and some orange slices in that as well. So it ought to be real tasty. So we'll have them later. And so that's where we're at. See you guys later. Okay, the chickens have been on about an hour and a half, about an hour and a half. And so we're gonna have a look at them. We're gonna leave here for a bit, but we're gonna take a quick peek before we go, show you guys how they're looking. Looking good. Let's look at the other one. Okay, let's come over here, see how the upright's doing. It's coming along. Yeah. Fire's still looking good. I put a little bit of water in that pan just because, and it's dripping as it steams out of the can. So, close her back up. And we are going to go down and feed some geese some bread. So, we're going to go down to Bass Pro for a little while. See you guys later. All right, chicken's been on about 3 hours, a little less, but close to that. So we're going to have a look and see what we got going on here. Oh, man, look at that. Yeah. Looks like I should have had something to catch the dripping, but that's all right. Our apple juice. We're not done yet. I think we still got some time. Let's go look at the other one. Let's see how this guy's going. Ooh, yeah. Yeah. Looking good. Check them later. All right, guys. Here they are, off the fire. That's the first one on the plate. And here's the second one's got a little darker bark on it, but not bad. So, two beer can chickens. Here's how they are. Here's how they turned out. Mashed potatoes, and we got dinner. So, have a good holiday. Thanks for coming by.